Don't use the word rental. This is subscription. Subscription ya, apa maksud dia selalu? Subscribe. Apa maksud subscribe ni?
Langgan.
So they don't use the word
rental.
Sewa. Sewa. LHD apa pening sekarang? Then either prof, let's discuss. They say the model, see the business model is moving. Tada. The business model is really moving. Saya suka itu je lah. I say, oh people, oh, how they move this thing? They want to run away from tax, but that's how they do it. Okay, okay, rental income. Can so expenses ni. So income, when income is received at once, the expenses must also be claimed in the respective business period to set off against the rental income. Okay, otherwise the expenses will not be allowed. So for that year, kalau 2022 rental income, you can boleh deduct the expenses for 2022. Jangan pula potong 2021 punya expenses. For that year assessment je lah. Okay. So you can make sure that whatever you claim is for the year. You cannot claim before, after, tak boleh. Okay. So you see this ada banyak-banyak dia punya. So you have the rental income. Kan? Tapi government ni bagus lah kan? Dia tak ada zalim. So, you can deduct many things from your rental account. Macam rumah you, your sewa tu. Biasanya apa yang first thing yang dia kena kena belanja? What they have to spend on that property? Maintenance. Kan? Repair. Maintenance. Kan? Rosak sana, rosak. Lagilah student duduk lagi rosak. We had a wonderful bungalow in Citra. Then when kita berhijrah, my wife polytechnic mengajar, saya dekat lah rumah saya dulu. So my wife kata nak enjoy saya, boleh tak kita bagi sewa? Dia kata tak apa lah, you carilah siapa nak sewa. So dia carilah student dia before we move out. After few months we went back tengok rumah. Masa balik tu dia kata kita jual boleh tak rumah. Saya kata you say you want to sewa, I agree. Now you say you want to sell up, tak tahan nak tengok rumah macam ni. Yeah, people stay in the house, it is not our house. Susah nak orang jaga. Akhirnya kita jual, we sold off the house. I got no property in Kedah. Habis lah property in Kedah. Tapi banglo di sana tak ada lah value sana. Kalau banglo di KL boleh ada juta kan. Tapi okey lah kan. And my banglo was very unique sebab it was designed by my adik saya yang arkitek tu. So kawan-kawan ramai pula nak minta. So saya pun naikkan harga to get the best price. So repair maintenance for sure, property, machine ke whatever, car ke kan, repair maintenance. And then cost of collecting rental, ini dah pakai agent pula kan. Kadang-kadang better to use agent right, but you use agent you kena lah incur the cost. Okay, and then interest on loan. Bila you ambil loan, you ambil financing, you kena bayar right, the profit margin ke apa semua tu, itu boleh tidak. You can deduct because it is an expense to you. Kan? You boleh deduct. Fire insurance. Itu satu hal pula. Kan? Takaful untuk fire dan sebagainya. Boleh deduct. You see, kalau you terima, kan, RM1,000 rental times 12, RM12,000. Macam-macam you boleh deduct. Apa? Repair. Kan? Apa lagi? Fire insurance. Apa lagi? Switch kan? Apa lagi? Tapi kena ada bukti lah. Faham? Mesti ada bukti, evidence, mesti kan? Apa lagi? Quit rent assessment. What is quit rent assessment? Cukai. Cukai apa? Cukai. Cukai pintu dan cukai tanah. Kan? Siapa yang ada property dia tahulah. Ni ujung bulan ni kena bayar semua. Cukai pintu dan cukai tanah. 31 Mei. 31 Mei ke sekarang? Kena bayar. Kalau tak, Kalau you tak bayar cukai pintu, cukai tanah within the day, apa jadi?
Ha?
Dia akan lelong lambat lagi. First, dia kenakan 10% penalti. Lepas tu dia akan tengok lah warning merah, letter, macam-macam merah dia akan hantar. Tapi setengah tu tak kisah kan. Even on the, kalau you ada tanah kosong, an empty land pun kena bayar juga. Kan? Cukai pintu, cukai tanah. Cukai pintu tak ada lah. Tapi patutnya tak, tak ada lah tanah tu kosong ni. Empty land pun dikenakan juga cukai pintu. Apa dia collect pun tak tahu. But you can deduct lah.
Okay.
And then renewable tenancy agreement macam you all ni, every year go back nak sign balik, boleh. Kan? Kena chop tak? Stamp tak? Tak payah stamp dah? Tak payah. Bagus dia baca-baca ni. Apa kena buat? Lawyer ada? Agreement ada? Itu lagi senang lah dia. Kan? Tak payah buat apa. Now, advertising cost. Why advertising? Advertising cost. To find, untuk first, you nak cari apa? Advertising ni, Edison tak logic anymore. It's not practical. Sekarang ni kalau you nak sewa rumah, macam mana you tahu rumah tu kosong? How do you know? Online. Tapi ni si zaman dah, apa kata, zaman dah habis. At least ini kadang-kadang not up to date. What they say is that advertising cost. So mana dulu ni kena advertise. Advertise ke mana? Newspaper, kan? Utusan Malaysia, Berita Harian. Sekarang mana ada? Nobody reads newspaper. Lagi apa? Ke mana? Mana-mana lah, kan? Yang nak cari orang nak sewa. Okay? Advertising cost is allowed, tapi not the first time tu. The first time because there's no income. Okay dah? You can only deduct when there's an income, kan? When there's no income, first time you nak cari orang, it cannot deduct. Itu maksudnya. The first time you cari orang nak sewa, the tenant, you cannot. You advertise lah dengan agent ke, dengan apa ke, tak apa. But because you got no income, you cannot deduct. So you cannot deduct that first. Lepas tu kita ada pest control. What is pest control? Anak-anak lah, itulah kan. Yes, you want to protect the property, kan? Kenalah. Okay je. Kan? So mana banyak lah yang kena buat benda. And service cost. What is service cost? Indah water, kan? Untuk bersihkan apa semua tu lah, kan? Indah water punya, kan? Kena bayar juga. Ini banyak orang tak bayar. Kalau ada sumbat baru dia tahu, kan? So you tanya lah, cakap tuan rumah, cik boleh potong banyak ni, kan? Bukan dia ni, kan? So ni lah. So rental income, receive from rental, lease industrial building, ini kita tengok industrial building. Industrial building apa dia? Factory, dock, wharf, jetty, warehouse. Bila ada factory, dia ada kilang, kita ada jetty, kan? Kita ada gudang, warehouse. It's called industrial building, bukan just normal building. It's an industrial building. Ini bukan industrial building, tapi boleh juga industrial building. Sebab apa? Faculty building ni industrial building ke tak? Nanti kita tengok pula definition tu, kan? Public university, itu saya lawan. Public university sebab dia tak generate income, dia kata. So it's not industrial building. Tapi kalau private university, dia generate income tak? So dia kata industrial building. Okay. So rental income. So you katakanlah gross income from factory, which is an industrial building, 60,000, 5,000 per month, 12 months, kan? Then allowable expenses lah. Quit rent boleh tolak, fire insurance boleh tolak, cost of repairing factory doors boleh tolak, toilets rosak boleh tolak, sewage cost boleh tolak. So adjusted income you get 51,000, okay? And then you less capital allowances. What is capital allowances? In tax, we call it the capital allowances. Kan? We don't call it depreciation. Nah, ini accounting tetap guna. We don't use depreciation. Nah, itu terminology in accounting. But in tax, it is capital allowances. Allowances given for the capital equipments, capital apa assets, sorry, equipments, capital asset. So macam ni lah, kan? Capital assets. So which is correct, kan? Dapat depreciation ni, dia akan jadi apa? Reducing kan? For katakan 10% per annum. 10% per annum. So dalam accounting ni, kalau you all tengok accounting, dia dah fix dah, betul tak? Dia dah fix dah, kan? Berapa persen, kan? For buildings apa semua, it's fixed. Tapi when you fix it, dia susah lah. The government want to move the economy, betul tak? Kan? Move the economy. So as I always say, the government ini kalau boleh dia nak encourage many things. The industry, how to move the industry, how to move the economy, kan? Itu yang penting dalam fiscal policy. So kalau dia bagi 10% je, tak move lah. But if you give more, mungkin you can move the economy, right? You can move the industry. So satu caranya lah, how to move the industry. Contohnya apa? You want people to buy computers. Okay? Computers. Nanti relief pun tengok lah, ada relief kalau you beli komputer. So maknanya bila you bagi relief, then many people buy computer, family buy. Dulu ada satu slogan apa? To encourage people to buy
Satu rumah satu komputer.
Betul lah tu, kan? Dulu tak ada madani. Sekarang ni dulu satu rumah satu komputer. The idea is what? So that every family has a computer. Betul tak? Internet pun boleh tolak juga. Ada relief, nanti isi pula. Internet boleh tolak, kan? So to encourage people to buy computer and use the internet, and then becomes computer savvy, internet savvy, kan? Bukan untuk tengok TikTok, tapi untuk belajar. But itu masalah tu, government bagi all this thing, dia nak tengok TikTok je, bukan untuk belajar. Itu sedih lah. So what happen is, how to move the industry? Number one, kan? Mana industri pun kena gain. Number two, taxpayer. Satu rumah, satu komputer. Ya tak? So, for taxpayer, you bagilah relief. Zini, you kalau bagi relief, dia dapat relief, dia tahu orang, saya beli komputer, saya boleh. Tidak, right? Untung tak? Kan? So, better. Okay. Cuma dia last time, dia bagi satu family ni, boleh claim after every 5 years. Mula-mula dia start every 5 years. Kita kata, komputer 5 tahun dah habis dah, kan? I think now it's 3 years ago. Tapi sekarang automatic in the system dah. I kalau dah claim dah, after 3 years dia tak boleh nak masuk dah. Next year tak boleh masuk, dia akan block. Bagus sistem macam tu. Kalau saya pun lupa, bila saya beli komputer untuk anak ke apa kan? This is for taxpayer, you get the relief. Tapi industri ni, industri ni, you bagi 10% tak cukup, isn't it? They want to make faster dan apa semua tu. So what you do is you give capital allowances, kan? Initial allowance, annual allowance, kan? Maksudnya apa? Initial allowance 20%, annual allowance 40%. So kalau lah macam tu, first year dia bukan depreciation 10%, dia boleh dapat 60% deduction. So they encourage the industry to go into computer dan sebagainya. Okay. Use more computers to do work. Sekarang what is the word? Company ni mesti apa? Mesti apa? Bukan IT savvy. Digitalization. Betul tak? Pernah dengar? How SMEs apa digitalize. So the way to digitalize is use of computer. Kalau you bagi 10% je macam accounting tu, tak jalan. So 20%, 40% initial allowance, annual allowance 60%. The second year 40% AA. Ya, IA tu sekali je 40%. 100%. Maksudnya apa? You use the computer, you can get your everything claimed by 2 years. Tak payah tunggu lama. So that's why in tax, dia punya calculation untuk certain thing tak ikut accounting. So orang yang tahu accounting tak semestinya tahu tax. Tapi orang yang tahu tax tahu accounting. Itulah kelebihan dia. Okay? Alright. Now, so this rental, okay, rental income. Okay, then ini adalah contoh-contoh dia tu. And this rental income juga sama juga. It can become 4A, not 4D. Okay, because you got too many businesses, you got too many properties, you can have too many machines ke apa semua tu lah. Then dia nampak sangat it's a recurring business. So ini jadi business, dia jadi 4A. Okay, first time, alright. Then royalty. Okay, the royalty. Royalty daripada mana? Copyright, artistic, scientific work, patents, design, model, plan, secret process, secret recipe. Then formulae. Banyak ni. You can get a lot of royalty. Okay, macam copyright buku. Okay, lagu, CD. Kan, patent, design, kan, semua engineering design, architectural design, model. Kalau tengok arkitek, ada saya arkitek, saya tahu lah dia buat model. Sebelum nak buat bangunan tu, dia kau model, cantik kau model-model. Tapi itulah, if you get money, is royalty income, yeah, from the model itself. Secret process. Secret process ni apa? Dia contohnya macam Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola dia ada secret formula lah. Dia air dia tu orang tak kisah sangat. Tapi yang paling mahal dia lah, the secret formula dia tu. Dia tak akan bagi secret formula. So at one time, the Indian government, many years ago, 40-50 years ago, the Indian government minta Coca-Cola bagi secret formula dekat government. Nampak? What did Coca-Cola did? Dia tak mau bagi. So dia kata, you must give us. Then only you can operate in India. India big market kan? Tapi what they did? They tutup factory, they tutup semua, they got out of India. Coca-Cola. Tapi actually, bagus kan minum Coca-Cola ni?
Tak.
Itu yang kita tak faham juga. Kalau dia tengok Arab ni, buka puasa, di mesti ada. Dia tak minum Coca-Cola, dia minum Pepsi Cola. Kalau you pergi ke Mekah ke apa tu, penuh Pepsi. Gila betul Arab ni, kan? They love Pepsi Cola. Buka puasa, iftar, tapi kena ada Pepsi. Saya kata, itu haram lah. Don't drink Pepsi Cola. But itulah the formula, the trademarks, radio, TV. Now this thing must tengok lah yang ada new modern lah. The new social media apa semua tu lukuh, how they do it then. And also know how. What's know how? Know how ni apa? Knowledge and skills. Saya kena cukai tak on knowledge?
Tak.
Yalah, kalau saya mengajar di universiti tak ada lah. Tapi if I teach outside,
Kena.
Okay. If I do consulting work, kena. I use my knowledge to ni, kena. Apa? Technical knowledge, industrial knowledge, kan? Dia ada semua ni. Industrial knowledge, technical knowledge, commercial knowledge, scientific knowledge, experience and skills. Semua kena. If you receive royalty, kan? Income derived, semua tu okay. So royalty include software. Okay, sekarang ni software lah. Reception to receive visual image, sound, transmitted to public by satellite, cable, fiber, optic, macam-macam. You receive royalty from all the sources ni. Sekarang ni lagi lah, canggih-canggih kan? Semua kena. Visual, sound, broadcasting, radio broadcasting, television broadcasting, satellite, cable, semua tu lah. Kan, so extension ni apa? Granting of right royalty to get any from use of rights. So property, know-how, information dan sebagainya. Semua tu adalah ni. So royalty is considered derived from Malaysia if payment of royalties made by government, state government, local government dan sebagainya. And then there is ada juga lah allowable deduction macam tadi kan. Rental pun ada, ni pun ada jugalah. Example, proofreading, novel. Kan nak tulis buku kan? Nak publish right? Kenalah ada proofreading, can be deducted from writing a novel. Adakah orang tulis novel sekarang ni? Ada. Masih ada lagi ya. Ha, kalau saya tengok pergi ke popular, saya pergi ke MPH pun dah tutup lah dekat Alamanda. Popular, apa banyak buku dia jual-jual? Budak-budak sekolah banyak lah. Saya sedih saya tengok zaman sekarang ni. Apa lagi buku yang dia jual? All the novels kan? Apa lagi buku dia jual? Ha? Ada tak buku-buku yang berilmu yang tinggi dan sebagainya? Ada juga buku apa? Contoh? Buku management ke apa ke ada ke?
Maksudnya tak ada, kalau latihan ada.
Itulah that shows that the culture tu dah tak ada lah. Okay. So now it's all I have to go back to Amazon. Kan, Shopee ke baru itu beli buku-buku yang ni lah popular. Apa lagi buku? Kedai buku mana lagi? MPH pun tutup dah ni. Sampai I think Syed Bukhari pun dah tak boleh tahan dah. Dia pun dah tutup. Alaman dah tutup. Bangi ada, kecil ada buat. Tapi saya pergi tengok Bangi, dia pun sama juga. Budak-budak punya buku, exercise. Lepas tu ada sikit-sikit novel pun no. Saya tengok ada tak buku ni. But saya dah beli dah Ocean number one. And then Blue Ocean Shift saya dah beli dah. The latest is they call it Beyond Disruption. Okay, maknanya How to build your business without disrupting. This is a nice interesting case study ni. Dia tengok banyak orang kata the economy is disrupted, technology disrupt. You disrupt, you destroy the others, barulah you boleh buat business. Your business can grow, right? But these guys Chan Kim and Rini ni, they're very good. They try to say very Islamic perspective. That is, you don't disrupt the other business, but you can still survive. You can be better than the other business. That's what we call it, beyond disruption. Buku tu baru keluar. Tapi saya dah sibuk sangat, tak order direct from them. So, I've been tengok MPH dengan popular. Ada tak buku ni? The latest book? Tak ada. Dia kata, Encik seorang je tanya. Okay. Mana orang baca buku-buku ni? Tapi yang Blue Ocean dengan Blue Ocean Shift tu, you tahu berapa dia jual? How many copies? Millions of copies. Okay. Tapi itulah. So proofreading, novel. Saya kalau boleh saya cakap dengan Alessia, tak payahlah ni. Novel-novel ni tak payah buang. Bagi ke orang yang tulis buku yang ilmu. Okay. Tu saya tengok yang Telaga Biru tu. Baguslah ustaz tu. Masih lagi nak cetak buku. Ikim petang-petang dia ada keluar. Kan dengan Quran dia dengan apa semua kan. Dan saya bila saya nak beli Quran yang apa? Nak bagi ke non-muslim. Oh susah nak cari. Itu satu hal lah. Saya cari merata dah. Susah cari. Kan Quran yang tak ada yalah ayat-ayat tu tak ada. Surah tu tak ada. Tapi all translated version tak ada. Susah. Tapi Allah, saya berdoa. Akhirnya ada pula satu persatuan dekat Pulau Pinang. Dia buat kan, PPIM ke apa, apa dia panggil? Persatuan yang Propagation of Islam. Propagation of Islam Pulau Pinang. Masya Allah. Saya contact dia, the lady tu kan. Dia mu'alaf juga. Saya kata I'm Mustafa, I like to buy this Quran apa semua dekat. Boleh kata yes tuan Haji boleh. Ini apa sebenarnya? Nama dia Saratan Abdullah. Saya kata Masya Allah bagus juga. And the way how they do dakwah, propagate Islam lah. Nanti di bina dan sebagainya. Dia datang juga ke sini. And then bila saya minta Quran ni, translator version ni yang tak ada. Inilah sebab kita inilah nak bagi kat kawasan Jepun apa semuanya, tak maulah kan, tak boleh lah dengan surah-surah dan ayat tu dalam bahasa Arab. So kena lah translated je version tu. Saya kata, how much must I pay Sister Sarah ni? Oh no, we give you free. Oh yeah, Alhamdulillah. Then I say, postage also free. Ah, tu macam ni orang berdakwah ni kan. FKP ni entah apa dakwah ni. Now exemptions. Exemptions, yeah. So you tengok semua ada exemption, eh? Dividend exemption, discount and exemptions, eh? Semua tadi tu lah kan? Rental pun tengok yang mana boleh deduct dan sebagainya. Exemption ni publication of a use or right to use any artistic work other than original painting, RM10,000. Publication of use or right to use any artistic work other than original painting ni, according this, itu tu ada tak sekarang zaman ni? Tape lah apa semua dekat Allah. Dulu ada lah yang cucu-cucu. Sekarang ada lah. Thumb drive ke apa. Ada lagi. Ada lah. Tapi mana orang pakai sangat kan. Dulu kalau tak, saya pun tak suka juga. Saya kena bawa thumb drive masuk sini. Lepas tu dia korap. Masuk balik ke komputer saya lagi korap. Sekarang dah okey sikit. So RM10,000. Okay. Other than original painting. Bukan original painting. Translation of the books, literary works. Ini kalau Ministry of Education, Ministry KPT minta AJ ni. Kan, then you nak buat translation. Itulah macam translate the Quran. Kan, translate dalam bahasa apa? Bahasa Inggeris ke? Saya minta Jepun ada tak? Minta Jepun tak ada. Tapi saya tahu di Jepun ada. Nama dia Yoshaka Omar, brother Yoshaka Omar. Jepun yang masuk Islam. Masya Allah, dia translate. And umur dia was 88 years old. Akhirnya, dia belajar dekat Al-Azhar. Stay in Egypt for almost 10 years. Lepas tu belajar bahasa Arab. He came back to Japan and then he translate in bahasa Jepun. Okay, from Kyoto lah. So, no exemption is done on the capacity of official duties. Tengok. So, kena tengok. Walaupun dia arah oleh kementerian, arah oleh AG, kan, you translate Quran ke buku ke from bahasa Jepun ke Melayu ke from bahasa English kan, English to Melayu ke, doesn't matter, but no exemption is done on capacity official. Kalau you official duty, maknanya you memang professor in linguistic, then you minta government minta you translate, no exemption. You get 20,000, no exemption. If not, then you get 12,000 exemption. So here 10,000, sini 12,000. And then publication of right used literary work and original painting 20,000. Tadi kan ini bukan original painting. Ini artistik kan? Artistik kan? Ini siapa yang menteri dulu yang suka art ni? Siapa? Dia sekarang ni speaker Dewan Negara, bukan Dewan Rakyat, speaker Dewan Rakyat Negara. Dia orang Jelebu. Siapa? Tan Sri. Dia lawyer tapi dia suka art ni. Siapa? Tan Sri Rais Yatim. Tahu tak? Pernah dengar Rais Yatim? Dia lah lawan. Kan? Dia lah lawan. Tahu tak? Macam mana kita tak appreciate art? Tapi ialah saya tengok oleh Japan, Korea, kan? China. Kita buat art juga, kan? Tulisan hot apa semua kan. Anak saya seorang tu memang seronok dia tengok. Tapi bila dia buat painting macam ni, itulah kalau jual, then you get royalty lah. Kan? 20,000. Okay, exemption ni. Individual performing atau participating cultural performance provided Ministry of Finance. No exemption perform on individual official duty. Kalau official duty, memang you pegawai dalam Kementerian Budaya apa? Saya tak tahu, lupa lah. Isi budaya dan sukan lagi. Ataupun budaya kebudayaan lain lah. Allah lah. Tapi you tak dapat exemption kalau you dapat duit. Tapi full exemption lah kalau yang lain. Musical composition, maknanya you untuk music 20,000. Kan? And then no exemption down ini sama jugalah. Kan? Fee honorarium, kan? Royalty by researchers for commercializing research finding, 50% tax exemption period 5 years from the date of payment. Okay, honorarium lah dan you dapat. So ini juga for non-resident, the rate is 10%, okay, remitted to within a month, must withholding tax, kan? Okay, ini contoh dia. Okay, and then premium income sama juga macam discount lah, kan? Okay, you kena masukkan dalam itu. Okay, the last one, the last one is pension income. So tadi kita ada 4D, katakan ada 4D ada, so kita ada 4D, rental, kan, premium, royalty. Kalau ada lah, 12,000. Tapi kita tengok juga ni, is it exempted ke tak? That exemption tu yang tadi kita cakap tu, all this exemption. But the last one is 4E. 4E ni adalah pension. Pension. So pension kita terima ni is taxable. Tapi kita tengoklah ada yang di exempted macam tadi juga. Kan? Okay. Bila you dah pension, derived from Malaysia, paid by government, kan? Mana you normally pension di Malaysia ni hanya government servant. Kalau lah private, tak ada lah. Kan? Tak ada lah, kan? And then pension paid to widow, child, relative, or dependent, gross income chargeable tax for recipient. Kan? Maknanya bayar selepas kematian siapa-siapa. Then, kan? Kalau suami dah mati, the husband is dead, wife dapat pension tak? Kalau lah katakan ada government servant, wife dapat pension tak?
Dapat.
Tapi kalau isteri dah mati, suami dapat pension tak?
Tak.
Hui, ada ke tu?
Ada.
Ada.
Suami mati, isteri dapat pension. Kalau isteri mati, suami dapat tak?
Tak dapat.
Hui, saya kena lawan juga buat. Gender equality lah. Kita pun tak faham. Sebab kalau dah suami tu dah bertua dah kan, 90 years old kan, dan katakan dia private sector, dia tak ada pension. Suami ni pula private sector. Kalau di government sector tak apa juga kan. So macam mana nak hidup? Kan? Yesterday I think my wife sent me another video ko. Pakcik ni dia kata dia bisnes banyak. Dia ada minyak, kedai minyak, kedai itu, kan, petropam, ladang, macam-macam dia ada. Lepas tu dia pun pergi silap pula, dia dah 7 orang anak ke whatever, dia dah transfer all the asset tu lah anak. Ada. Lepas tu sekarang ni tak ada siapa nak nak tengok dia pula, dia kata. Sedih jugalah. Pakcik tu mungkin tak faham ko macam mana nak. Yalah, you boleh nak ni kan, hibahkan you punya harta ni, you kena tengok dalam you punya agreement tu. Masa kita hidup, kita jangan bagi. Kita siap-siap lah wasiat semua, tapi tak, you cannot take my harta. After I'm dead, then you're okay. When I'm alive, no one plans to me. Yeah. So, sama juga saya tengok ada tansi-tansi yang dia nak bagi. Dia dah bagi dengan anak-anak ni semua tu, tapi dia nak bagi untuk wakaf. Adalah dua banglo. So satu banglo dia duduk, satu lagi banglo. Yang lain anak semua dapat banglo dah. Satu banglo tu dia nak bagi wakaf ke ustaz. Ya Allah, gaduh sakan anak-anak tu dengan menantu, dengan cucunya apa semua tu. Nangis Tan Sri tu. Itulah saya kata. I always tell my children, all these assets belong to Abah. None of my assets belongs to you. Don't own my asset. I own my asset. I work for my asset. You nak mencari lah sendiri. Kan? So exempted pension apa? Pension from Malaysia. Macam government lah kan. Kita kerja government, exempted lah. Kan? And then retirement was due to ill health, reaching the age of 55. Ini sama juga lah tengok gratuity. Kan? Gratuity paid to pension. Gratuity paid to president, deputy speaker, member of senate. Tengok tu, ini orang parlimen ni. Kan, pension bayar pada president, member of senate, speaker, deputy speaker. Ni house of representative apa? Dewan rakyat. Speaker, apa dia dapat semua free. Kan, so exemption subject to apa? Pension derived from Malaysia, recipient resident Malaysia, ataupun due to ill health or reaching at age 55. Okay. Apa lagi yang exempted? Individual receive more than one pension. The highest pension, higher amount will be exempted. Wound or disability member of Malaysian Commonwealth ni, the pension granted to widow offers under any written law or approved scheme yang exempted. So receive more than one pension. Boleh tak orang, ada tak yang boleh dapat more than one pension? Boleh tak dapat more than one pension? Boleh tak dapat more than one pension? Ada contoh tak? Siapa? 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 Saya. Ah, ya, betul. Saya government servant. So kalau saya ada pension ni, saya dapat pension. Oh, dia kalau satu pekerjaan tu. Satu je lah. Ada tak manusia ataupun yang apa tu yang boleh dapat more than one pension?
Ada.
Siapa? Siapa? Menteri. Ah, okey. Sebab dia kan dekat speaker apa semua tadi kan? Ah, okey. Kalau you tengok, saya nak tengoklah menteri dalam beberapa tahun nanti dia harap-harap akan jadi menteri. Sebab UAE dah ramai ada menteri. USIM ada menteri tak? Belum lagi tak? InsyaAllah lah. Kita doa lah kan? Kan? Mula-mula dia jadi apa? Wakil rakyat. Lepas tu dia jadi apa? Timbalan menteri. Betul? Lepas tu dia jadi apa?
Presiden.
Menteri. Lepas tu dia jadi apa? Timbalan Perdana Menteri. Dua kali pula tu. Lepas tu dia jadi apa?
PM.
Dua kali juga. So, once you serve one term, 5 tahun, sini dapat pension tak? Dapat. You serve one term. Sini dapat pension tak?
Dapat.
After one term. Sini dapat pension tak?
Dapat.
Sini dapat pension tak?
Dapat.
Sini dapat pension tak?
Dapat.
Dua kali dapat. Bukan dua kali. Dua kali jadi PM, dua kali dapat. At one time, 20 years ago, kita gaduh. 20 years ago, semua tu exempted. Saya kata mengarah betul dia buat. Dia ada duduk parlimen, dia buat undang-undang, untung dia. Kita pula yang kerja teruk-teruk, satu pension. Nasib baik lah exempted. But only one. But they get how many pension? And at one time, 22,000, everything was exempted. Tuan dia kata, all government pension, oh ni exempted. Oh kita mengarut. So now that's the word. If an individual receives more than one pension, the highest pension or the higher amount will be exempted. Maknanya orang tu dah jadi PM dua kali. Ada. Ada. Ha. Yang mana yang highest? PM lah kan. Tengok. Ha. Ini exempted. Hak ni tax. Hak ni tax. Hak ni? Tax. Hak ni?
Tax.
Fair?
No.
Fair tak fair?
Fair.
Very fair.
Fair.
Okay. Itulah maksud dia yang those who receive more than you. Macam kami ni satu pension je. Kan? Tak ada dua pension. But wakil rakyat lah yang banyak pension. Dia claim tu. Itu dia tengah cakap. Lain kali jumpa wakil tanya dia. You dah jadi TPM ni, berapa pension you dapat? Kan? Berapa pension you dapat? Kan? Untung selalulah. Kan? Okay. So, annuity sama juga. Kan? This is macam inilah. Annuity paid by life insurers. Exempted from tax. Kan? Receive kan? Alimony payments. Also inilah. Tapi kita tengoklah. Alimony untuk wife. Dibayar macam mana kan to the wife yang dah cerai ke apa semua tu kan. So annuity paid by life insurance ni exempted from tax. Life insurance ni takapul dan sebagainya lah. Most of the listing. Alright. Okay. Periodical alimony juga termasuk juga alimony for the wife yang dah cerai. Okay. So this is on the ni. So 4F ni tak ada sangat unless of course macam cerita dia kata win a prize from television program kan. So dia tak involve 4A, 4B, 4C, 4D. So 4F kata mungkin dia terimalah hadiah-hadiah yang besar-besar from competition dan sebagainya. Alright. So kita take a break and then kita tengok yang ni employment income. So samping-samping tu you buatlah dengan kawan-kawan. Dan kita keluar ke. Oh sini. Oh macam tu. Okay. So dalam ghost ada ini kan eh? So this is a simple case about section 13. Section 13 dulu lah kan? Sebab 4B on employment income. So understand, read, understand. Tak apalah, dalam kawan-kawan bincang dulu to find out based on this Encik Fazil ni, income ni, can read properly, analyze. So finally kita kena tengok what is the statutory income for Encik Fazil year assessment 2022. Okay, so we'll start with section 13. Sebab ini employment income. Section 13, 1A ada tak? 1B ada tak? 1C ada tak? 1D ada tak? Kan? Then macam tadi lah. Finally kita nak look at what is the statutory income ni from A, B, C, D, E. Kalau ada, kan? Kalau ada, then for 2022, kan? Apa dia dah dapat dan sebagainya. Then mungkin next week saya akan mungkin that becomes our yang tadi lah individual assignment bila dah ada 4B dah ada, 4C dah ada, 4D itu complete, 4D, 4E kan, is complete. Maknanya barulah kita buat one assignment untuk ni. Dan tadi kita dah bincang next week Friday midsem exam 8 hingga 10 malam. Betul tadi?
Betul.
Through dalam goals Okay, so nak break boleh. Dalam 5 minit ke apa pun, and then we come back sebab kita ada sampai pukul 11. And then, kita cuba baca. So, read.